إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today is the 11th of Sha'ban, the year 1431 after Hijrah. And Sha'ban is the month that comes right before Ramadan. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said regarding this month, كما في سنن الترمذي والنسائي من حديث أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنهما ذلك شهر يغفل عنه كثير من الناس. A lot of people do not pay attention to the importance of this month, to the virtue of this month. What the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is referring to here, that this is the month when you prepare yourselves before Ramadan. A statement that I repeat all the time. Our young brothers who are talking, you're not supposed to talk in the khutbah. Don't speak in the khutbah. Is the month that comes before Ramadan. And a statement that I always say, that a lot of Muslims, they lose Ramadan before Ramadan. They wait until the month is here, and then they are not prepared mentally, physically, and then they end up committing maximum 2-3 days, and then they vanish, and then they reappear again the night of Laylatul Qadr. For them, they think it's the 27th. Even so, there are a lot of hadith that states that it could be in a different night than the night of the 27th, in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And they think this way they have won Ramadan. They have succeeded in Ramadan. They have achieved the unachievable in Ramadan, because they did not pay attention to the month of Sha'ban. In this month, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast more than any other month. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this to prepare himself for fasting. There is also a statement that is circulating amongst the predecessors of the Ummah, that the month of Sha'ban is the month of the Qurra, the month of those who recite the Quran. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given that attribute to this month, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, the month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed. Now, you do not train yourselves to recite the Quran before Ramadan. You wait until Ramadan is here, and then you open the Quran. One page done. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said regarding this month, ذلك شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله. In this month, your deeds will be presented and lifted to be presented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I like my deeds to be presented to Allah when I am fasting. وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One act, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you must do in the month of Sha'ban, which is repentance, tawbah. Subhanallah, the ayat, the verses in the Quran and the ahadith, the statements of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding tawbah in the Quran are overwhelming, moving. They move a rock. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zumar, a verse that the scholars of tafsir, they said about it, arja ayah fi kitabillah. If there is a verse in the book of Allah that gives the most hope, is this verse, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell my servants who transgressed too much, despair not from the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all sins, because He is the forgiving, He is the merciful. This verse in Surah An-Nisa must be understood in conjunction with this verse that I just quoted, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive that you commit shirk. You associate someone in worship or in prayer with him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. And he will forgive everything else to whomever he wills. What is meant in this verse? That if you die with that shirk, even if you commit shirk in this dunya, you could repent from that shirk. في سورة المائدة, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about those who say Allah is Jesus, or Jesus is Allah. Subhanallah. لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم. Disbelievers are those who say Allah is the Messiah, the son of Maryam. Another verse, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٌ. Disbelievers are those who say Allah is one of three. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Shouldn't they repent? Shouldn't they ask for forgiveness for that shirk? And if they do, Allah will accept them back in this dunya. But what is meant in the verse in Surah An-Nisa, if you die with the shirk, but even in this world, if you commit shirk, you still can repent from it by saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في سنن الترمذي من حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه حديث إلهي. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, يا ابن آدم, O son of Adam, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا لا تشرك بي شيئا. If you come to me with sins that fill all of earth, which is impossible. And in the 70, 80, 100 years that you live, even if you sin every second, you will not be able to fill earth with sins. But if you do, if you go back to Allah with earth filled with sins, but with one condition, لا تشرك بي شيئا, without committing shirk, أتيتك بقرابها مغفرة, I will meet you with the same quantity in forgiveness. شوف, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء. If your sins, the amount of sins that you have committed, if you pile it up, and if it reaches the heaven, the sky, Allah will forgive you. Where do you find another God like this one? Where? Where? Subhanallah. The issue here also that He does not need you. You see, that's what you need to realize. Allah does not need you. Allah is free of needs. في الحديث الإلهي في صحيح مسلم, حديث أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله عنه, وفيه, in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم اجتمعوا على أتقى قلب رجل رجل منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. If the first of you, Adam عليه السلام, and the last soul born will have the heart of the most righteous, pick up a man out of the human race, from the jinn race, the most righteous. All of us have this heart. This will not increase. This will not add anything to what Allah owns. In the other hand, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ, if the first of you, وَآخِرَكُمْ, the last of you, وَإِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ, human and jinn, اجتمعوا على أفجر قلب رجل منكم, of all of us will have the heart, والعياذ بالله, of the most wicked, ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيء. This will not decrease anything to what Allah owns. قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم. If you disbelieve, Allah does not need you. But yet, subhanallah, يعني لله أشد فرحا بتوبة أحدكم من Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joys so much because of your repentance than this man. والحديث في مسلم من حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. What is the story of this man? Someone who is traveling in the desert. ونحن نعرف أن الصحراء سماها العرب مفازة. مفازة means if you go through it and you come out of it alive, فزت. For this man is having all his provision on the back of his camel. And he's traveling through the desert. His water, his food, all his livelihood on the back of this camel. He got tired. He needed to sleep. And he forgot to tie his camel. Or he did not tie his camel. While he's asleep, the camel ran away. He went around in the desert looking for the camel because the camel is his life. Without the camel, he's done. He's too deep in the desert. He got tired. He decided that I will go back to the place where I lost the camel in the first place and I'll wait. He was so tired, he fallen to sleep or he fainted. حسب الأقوال. He opens his eyes like this. He already given up hope that he is to make it. He is opening his eyes like this. He finds the camel standing by his head. You can imagine how much joyful this person will be. He had an excessive joy that he had made a statement. He actually made a statement. If this statement would have passed through the heart, it would turn him into a kafir. But he did not mean it. You know what he said? He said, "Oh Allah, Ya Rabb, Allahumma, Anta abdi wa ana rabbuk. You are my slave and I am your God." Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Akhta'a min shiddatil farah." He made a mistake because of excessive joy. Shuf, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more joyful. Meanwhile, he does not need you. Remember, he does not need you. But he is more joyful than this man when you repent, when you come back to him. في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه إن الله ليبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار. Every single day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends his hand to you. Every day he extends his hand to you if you have sinned at night to repent. وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ. And he extends his hand to you at night, every night, if you have sinned during the day, to repent and to come back to Allah. As a matter of fact, كما في صحيح البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said, إذا كان الثلث الأخير من الليل, the last third of the night, Allah سبحانه وتعالى descends from his throne in a way that we don't know how. Don't even try to visualize how he descends. Like al-istiwa. Al-istiwa ma'loom. Wal-kayf majhool. Wal-imanu bihi wajib. Wal-su'alu anhu bid'ah. How he descends is known. Believing in it is mandatory. Asking how is a bid'ah. But he descends. Every single night. And he calls upon you. هل من مستغفر فأغفر له؟ هل من تائب فأتوب عليه؟ There is any person who wants to repent, anyone who's seeking forgiveness, I'll forgive you. When you're asleep. Wallahi, by Allah, if a human being, لو آدمي قرع عذابك, comes and knocks on your door, asking if you want something, and you do not wake up for him, he will do this more, maybe 2, 3, 4 nights, and after that, you're not going to see him. Every single night, Allah calls upon you, the last third of the night. Do you want to repent? And we're feeling comfy in the bed. We don't wake up. We don't open the door. But yet he still comes back to you the following night. What else do you want? What else do you want? A lot of Muslims, brothers and sisters in Islam, once we talk about tawbah, they think tawbah is not for them. It's not for you. What do you mean tawbah? What did I do wrong? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا. He calls upon you the attribute of Iman. أَثْبَتَ لَكَ الْإِيمَانِ وَطَلَبَ مِنْكَ التَّوْبَةِ. He already called you with the attribute of belief, and yet he's asking you to repent. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Repent, all of you. Come back, all of you, to Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, believers. When we talk about repenting and tawbah, and repenting basically is to come back to Allah. Taba ya'ni aba. You come back to Allah. You see, whatever you do of disobedience, distance you from Allah. If you are engaged in a sin, every time that you commit that sin, you're like traveling far away from Allah. Tawbah is you come back. Number one, by giving up that sin and adopting acts of obedience. When we talk about tawbah and repentance, it does soften the hearts. And it does make you feel good. But once it comes to a commitment, hardly anybody makes it. You go out of here. Okay, Sheikh, I will. Let me just finish my high school and enjoy the college a little bit with the, and then after that I repent. Or someone else will say, let me just make sure that I have maybe $50,000 in the bank, so we make sure that, and then we'll repent. And the other one, let me just, you know, I'm still young sheikh, you know. I'll go, from, you know. Ya akhi, I tell you something. Provide for me a covenant that you can make with the angel of death. Where the angel of death agrees, he will not come to take your soul until you actually do that. Then it's okay. Then that you're fine. Al-maut. Death comes by all the sudden. Children, infants die. Youth die. 15, 16, 17, 18. ما فيش أصلاً عمر للموت. There is no age for death. A person would be planning and thinking about years or days ahead of time, and his coffin is already prepared. Somebody already have made his coffin. All you have to do is go and buy it. خلاص. You have no guarantees. You have no guarantees. Brothers and sisters in Islam, sins have serious consequences or ill effects للمعصيه عواقب المعصيه لها شؤم. When you sin, there are consequences, not only in the graveyard. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about those who lie, they will be punished in the graveyard. Those who commit adultery will be punished in the graveyard. Those who deal with riba, they will be punished in the graveyard. Those who do not pray the five daily prayers, they will be punished in the graveyard. Hadith Samar ibn Jundub fi kitab al-Ru'ya, Sahih al-Bukhari. Lengthy hadith. I don't want to go there. But in the graveyard, there are consequences for the sins. In the day of resurrection, the day that is 50,000 years long, there are consequences in the sins of the sins. Enough. Enough this verse. وَهُمْ يَحْمِلُونَ أَوْزَارَهُمْ عَلَىٰ ظُهُورِهِمْ أَلَىٰ سَاءَ مَا يَزِرُونَ. Imagine all the sins that you have committed in this dunya and you did not repent of or asked Allah to forgive you of. It will be transformed. كان في ماكدونالدز زمان كده بيعملوا حاجة توي كول ترانسفورمر. Transformed. السن. Adultery, drinking, lying, backbiting, gossiping. It will take a physical form. And the sinner, وهذا قول السدي رحمه الله من التابعين. And the sinner, in explaining this verse في سورة الأنعام, and the sinner will carry it on his back. Imagine carrying your sins for 50,000 years long on your back. Carrying it in your back, going around the people on resurrection day, carrying the sin. A major sin that you have not asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you for could be the reason for you to go to the hellfire for a while, even if you're a Muslim, by the way. يا أخت لو سمحت لو تأخذ البنت هذه يعني حتى الأخوات يسمعن بارك الله فيك. طيب الله. Even if you're a Muslim and you have committed a major sin and you did not repent of, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who will decide this for sure, not us, not me, not you. You could go to the hellfire for years. Even so, you're saying, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. وهذه العقيدة الصحيحة. إياك أن تحيد عن هذه العقيدة. Don't you dare believe something but this. مرتكب الكبيرة في الإسلام. Someone who commits a major sin in Islam could go to the hellfire, but لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله will take him out of the hellfire one day. And this is the virtue of this word. كلمة الشهادة, كلمة التوحيد. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة يوما من الدهر. Here is a portion of the hadith that we always forget. وَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ قَبْلَ ذَٰلِكَ مَا أَصَابَ. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله in this dunya will go to Jannah one day. One day. Even if he has to go and experience some punishment in the hellfire. فالمعصية هذه that you're engaged in could take you to the hellfire. For years, Allah knows best. How many years? 100, 200, 300? وهكذا. But a lot of Muslims do not realize that the sin has ill effect and impact on you in this life. In this life. Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما has a beautiful statement. He said, إن للطاعة نورا في الوجه. إن للطاعة ضياء في الوجه ونورا في القلب وسعة في الرزق وقوة في البدن ومحبة في قلوب الخلق. When you obey Allah سبحانه وتعالى, these five things will happen. Your face will be shiny. You will look happy. نظرة الآخرة هذه, you will get a share of it. وجوه يومئذ في الآخرة ناظرة, you will get a share here. Brightness in the face, light in the heart, your heart will be alive. You see, this limb that we talked about last khutbah, حياتها الطاعة واجتناب المعاصي. What gives your heart life is obeying Allah and staying away from the sin. قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. O ye who believe, implement what Allah and the Messenger are commanding you to implement. This will give you life. That is the life of the heart. A lot of people are dead. والله يا أخي, because their hearts are dead. Their bodies are moving graveyards. The only thing that is left, dig a hole in the ground and bury the heart and the body. Because the heart is dead. أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يمشي به في الناس كمن مثله في الظلمات ليس بخارج منها. Is the one who was dead, dead of the heart, dead of in the heart, and we're giving him life, and his heart now is shiny, is receiving. So obedience will reflect a shine in your heart. Three, سعة في الرزق. يعني every single day we wake up fighting for the dollar and the cent. يا أخي, right here. نوح عليه السلام, once he was preaching to his people, he tells them this. فقلت استغفروا ربكم. Oh Allah, I said to them, ask Allah to forgive you, repent from your sins. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. He is forgiven. Look what will happen if you repent and ask for forgiveness. One, يُرْسِلُ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Rain will fall, رزق. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ. He will give you money. وَبَنِينَ, children. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. Because of what? Because of what? Giving up the sin. So the sin has an impact on your rizq. If you're having a hard time, akhi, earning your dollar, repent and you will see. And trust Allah. Don't do it because you're trying Allah. Do it because you trust Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِعَادِ. وسعة في الرزق. شوف, حتى يعني, even if you have a provision, if Allah has blessed you with a rizq that you're well off, your way to guard that ni'mah is not to sin. قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, وضرب الله مثلا قرية كانت آمنة مطمئنة يأتيها رزقها رغدا من كل مكان فكفرت. Allah has set a parable, a town, secure. The rizq comes to this town, the provision comes to this town from everywhere. Instead of being grateful, by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they disbelieved and they started sinning. What happens? فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them wear, look at this, the garment of hunger and fear. Subhanallah, التعبير القرآني ما له مثيل. That you will wear a garment of fear and hunger. اجري يا بن آدم اجري, making the money is not working. And you make it, and then you receive a phone call, the sales tax, you did not pay your taxes the last 10 years, we need your money out. You could earn it too. Done. وهكذا. رزق. رزقك. إذا كنت في نعمة فرعها فإن الذنوب تزيل النعم وحطها بطاعة رب العباد فرب العباد سريع النقم. If Allah has blessed you with a bounty, guard it with obedience. إياك, Allah will take it away from you. Allah will take it away from you. ضياء في الوجه, brightness in the face. نورا في القلب, light in the heart. سعة في الرزق, your provision. Four, قوة في البدن. قوة في البدن. Strength in your body. When Sayyidina Hud was preaching to his people, the people of Ad, or the people of Ad, those giants, يعني the length of the man was 40 feet long. نحن نعرف أن the size of the human being started going down, going down, going down. We are like this. Sayyidina Adam was 60 something feet. The people of Ad were 40. شوف, he was telling them that واستغفروا ربكم ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. Look, ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم. He will increase you in strength. In strength. احنا ليه بنشوف ال يعني سبحان الله names of diseases that never we heard about. Mad cow disease, chicken disease, swine disease, and later on snake disease, and then ant disease, and cow this. Where will we get this from? ظهور المعصية. في سنن ابن ماجه حديث صححه الشيخ الألباني, حديث that he is authenticated. He said, if the people would commit the sin openly, Allah will afflict them with diseases that their ancestors did not experience. AIDS and all these things. Why? وهكذا. Comes in number five. I'm still quoting the statement of Abdullah ibn Abbas. وَبُغْضًا فِي وَمَحَبَّةً فِي قُلُوبِ الْخَلْقِ. الحسنه will make the people like you. But the sin will turn the people against you. Because the fact of the matter is, the one who controls the hearts is Allah. إِنَّ قُلُوبَ بَنِيِّ آدَمْ بَيْنَ أُصْبُعَيْنِ مِنْ أَصَابِعِ الرَّحْمَنِ يُقَلِّبُهَا كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. Hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhuma fi sahih Muslim. The hearts of the children of Adam are between two fingers of the fingers of Allah. So if you obey Allah, Allah will turn the hearts of the people to like you. إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا نَادَى يَا جِبْرِيلِ. If Allah loves one of His servants, He will call upon Jibreel. في صحيح البخاري حديث أبي هريرة إني أحب فلانا فأحبه. I love so and so, love him Jibreel. Jibreel will call upon the dwellers of the heavens, the angel. إن يا ملائكة إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبه. Allah loves so and so, love him. Look at the end of the hadith. ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض. And his acceptance will be placed in the hearts of the believers. وهكذا. I want to close by this. Sins have impact on you. يا أخي والله, it turns you into humiliated. Humiliated. Allah will humiliate you. يقول لك الحسن البصري إني لا أعرف I know when I sin I know when I sin I see the consequences of my sin in the manner that my wife and my animal treat me. تلاقي الدنيا كده لخبيط مش ذل. يقول لك لو طقطقت بهم البغال. حسن البصري. If you're riding very nice, good looking horses that walks like this, tuck, 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 like a nice car, huh? Whatever it is, I have no idea, like Bima or whatever one of these cars these days. وَهَمْلَجَتْ بِهِمُ الْبَرَاذِينَ And they are riding, they have the best resources. فَإِنَّ ذُلَّ الْمَعْصِيَةِ لَا يُفَارِقُ وُجُوهَهُمْ The humiliation because of the sin does not leave your face, their faces. أَبَى اللَّهُ أَبَى اللَّهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يَذِلَّ مَنْ عَصَاهُ Allah refuses but to humiliate someone who disobey him. Like ماشي كده الإنسان اللي disobedient to Allah goes around begging people. Can you please help me, أخي? I don't have this. لكن الإنسان المطيع لربه عزيز. من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم Brothers and sisters in Islam What was it that brought Satan from being the طاووس الملائكة elevated with the angels down to earth rejected cursed a dweller of the hellfire but the sin what was it that took our father and mother Adam and his wife from Jannah to Dar al-Shaqa to earth but the sin what was it that caused earth to drown at the time of Nuh, but the sin. What was it that caused the angels being commanded by Allah to go and turn the villages of the homosexual, the people of Lut, upside down, but the sin. What was it that turned some people into apes in this world, but the sin. What was it that turned some people into porch vines, khanazir, but the sin? Allah is giving you and giving the ummah a chance. That chance comes once a year, the month of Ramadan. Free yourself from all of this. You have a chance. Shahr Ramadan is coming. But again, I end with the statement that I began with. Don't lose Ramadan before Ramadan. And if you do not repent before Ramadan, most probably you will lose Ramadan before Ramadan. Come back to Allah. Return. Make your tawbah before the month begins. So that you're going into the month with a clean heart. With a new agenda. Tawbah will also be, inshallah, the topic of the next khutbah, inshallah. Allahumma arzuqna qabla al-mawti tawbah. Allahumma arzuqna qabla al-mawti tawbah. Allahumma aj'al al-Qur'an al-azima rabi'a qulubina. Wajala'a ahzanina wa dhahaba humumina ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma dhakirna minhuma unsina wa alimna minhuma jahilna. Allahumma inna nastaghfiruka min jami'i al-dhunubi wal-khataya wa natubu ilayk. اللهم بلغنا رمضان يا أرحم الراحمين واجعلنا من هؤلاء الذين يفوزون بالتوبة والمغفرة في هذا الشهر الكريم اجعلنا من عتقائك في هذا الشهر المبارك يا رب العالمين أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أقم الصلاة